Hello, my name's Anthony Hall, and today's tutorial we're going to be modelling this Terminator chip. So I've decided to do this just because I'm going to try and do more modelling tutorials. I just don't think there's enough out there for Lightwave, and so when I get time I'm going to concentrate on doing like modelling. So here's an actual test render, which is native render, and here's the model. So what we're going to do is try and get to the stage where I'll show you how to model this, and then I'll do a part two where we can texture it and render it in the Lightwave native but also in Octane. So let's get started. So I've got some reference images that I got from the internet, which beforehand I would suggest you do. So here's an example that I'm going to use, and then I've also got some glass cases and stuff. So we're going to start by, under the create tab, use the box tool, and we're going to click and draw out an area for a shape that we can use for the kind of main body. Now if I went on this, when I select the box tool and I've drew it out in my top view and pulled it up in the right view like so, you'll see these orange handles. So N on your keyboard will bring the numerical up, so you can actually do this numerically if you wish as well. Now also on this I've got the smooth edges on, so it's smooth the edges. So if I tip that, if I turn this off completely like so, you'll see it's just got rid of that. So what we'll do is we'll start with that kind of edge. So let's just bring this in. We're looking up here, so it's going to be how big will it be roughly? I think we're talking it's going to be around let's bring this out. Let me zoom out a little bit. So we need to make it around, I think the length's around 8 centimeters. So let's bring it up to 8, but then let's bring the depth a bit further out. So we kind of got this. Now this is probably the overall length, so maybe it looks a bit too long. So let me just fix. On the actual image, I've got to have these 15 boxes and whatever this bit is, and then obviously this bit as well. So what we need to do is kind of size it and try and figure out how long it is. But whenever you're modeling stuff, try and model it to real world sizes, it'll make things loads better. But let's go with this roughly. Okay, so as you can see, just nearly 6 centimeters in the length. So we've got that. And now what I need to do is make all the boxes. So for the boxes, what I'm going to do is, under the layers here, we've got our first layer. Double click it. We can call it, I'll just call it main. I'm going to click below and then click on the little B to put it in the background. And then I just need some boxes. So we'll draw out a box in the top and side, and I'll place it through so I can roughly see what kind of size. And why I'm doing this, I'm looking at my reference image on the other screen to see roughly the size and stuff and how it looks. Now with this, these boxes are quite they've kind of rounded. I've got to be able to fit 5 on here. Also, I'm not bothered if this needs to be extended, we can do that. So I've got one. Why you've got it selected and it's orange, let's bring up the numerical, and this time we will smooth the edges. So we'll smooth the edges by, so currently it's 1 mil, okay, by 4. Now if you need to go smaller than this, I think it's called micro millimeters maybe, and it'll be like, so if I wanted to go smaller, let's say I put 200 um and press return, that's like the micro ones that are smaller. So you can go smaller, I think you can go smaller than that either, but yeah. And let's just stick with 1 mil, because I quite like the roundness of that, and by 4 maybe. So again, once I've got one, we've done it. The next thing we need to do is make 15 of them. So to multiply down to array, click array, numerical will bring it up. Let's have a look what we've got. We've got 1 by 3. So we need 5 by 3, and then we need to offset them. So that's 10 mil. So let's go the other way. Let's see what 10 mil is. So roughly that's 15 boxes, but the area in between is not the same. So I would say it needs to be something like this, 10 by 10. So what we'll do, we'll stick with that. So 5, 3, 10 by 10. We'll shut this down, press space bar. And then what I'm going to do is just under modify, use the move tool and move it into place. So they need to be overlapping slightly. So this is where we'll just use the size tool. And why are they all sizing together? Okay, let's just go onto mouse at the bottom and let's just size them up. So we've got something like that. So they're just overlapping the edge. And then let's turn on the main so we can see. That's all right. So we've done that. Now let's make this thing. No idea what it is. So it's like a rectangle shape with three rectangle holes. Don't know what that little bit is in there, but I will leave that. So for this, let's go on another new layer. Put the other stuff in the background. Again, create box, top view, drew it out. Now it's using the same settings as I did for the box, which is good because they're roughly around the same. And I'm zooming in and I'm just lining them up roughly and deciding on what deciding on how thick this is, which is, I don't think it's really thick looking at my reference image. Let's say that. Now if you want to edit that while it's live, numerical, and you can bring it up, and then you can again mess about with the settings if you want. I'm just going to say fine. So I'm going to say that's okay. So now what I need to do is have, I want to make three little boxes and boolean. So that means subtract them and cut into this shape. Now to do that, what I'll do is I'll use the same shape. So while I'm on it, I'm going to Control C on your keyboard to copy in a new layer below it, and then Control V to paste. Now I'm going to put the main layer in the background, and then we just need to size this down. So let's just go to modify size, let's size it down. Let's use a stretch tool as well. So what we're doing is we're stretching it in, and then I'm going to jump between the stretching and the move tool. So it's T, and what I need is I need a certain length so I can actually do, and it's in that back view, let's make sure it's going through about there. I'm going to make sure it's a certain length so when we actually do the array tool to do three, it'll do hopefully three. So there we go, we've got one, it's going through. Multiply, array, numerical, we don't want five, we just want three, and we want it going through the other way. So actually let's say that, so 9mm by 3 on the X, as you can see that roughly that. Let's shut that down. Let's just move it so it's a little bit more centered. And so we've got it cutting through like that. So now what we need to do is switch the layers like so. So the little boxes are in the background because they're the cutting objects. So it's like negative from positive. Then we go to construct boolean. It'll be on subtract. So we're going to subtract the negative from the positive. And then there we have it. And then the old cutting tools we don't need. So I'm just going to delete on the keyboard. And then what we've got so far is this. However, we need this bit here. So, and also I need to smooth these edges of the main body because they look too sharp. So easiest thing, at the bottom here, look. Make sure you're on polygons and select that front poly. Then use the move tool and just move it out. If you hold control down, it will lock it to the axis. So let's move it so far. Let's say there. Okay. Now the problem we've got, if I just go on the main, is there isn't any polys here to pull out these bits. So let's just make some. So we go to detail, edit edges. This lets you manipulate the edges, but also add them. So what we're going to do is when you hover over an edge, we're going to right mouse click to add a row of edges, and we're going to bring them to the side like so. And then I'm going to do it again and bring it to the side, and I'm drag it roughly to the, so they're around the same size. You can edit these after as well. So left mouse click lets you edit them. So let's say you think you did that, and you think, well, actually I want to move that one. go back to edit, and this time when you go over it, you can move it by left mouse clicking. So once you've done that, let's select these two polys, turn everything else on a minute. Let's have a look, and then let's just move them out. So for moving them out, extruding them, let's use the multi-shift. So multi-shift lets you bring it out side to side, up and down, so it lets you kind of bring them out as well. It's just another bevel tool, really. Forward, so spacebar to drop the tool, and then you can just click and drop these like that. So if we look at the main now, it's done, but it's really sharp. So let's use a rounder tool. Click on the rounder tool and numerical. Now, when it comes up, it might be default to like a really silly size. I'm not sure. So what you've got to do is make sure that the size that you've got works. So, for instance, let's put in 250 um for micro. So this is for micromillimeters. So it's below millimeters, obviously. So we get this smoother edge. When you first use this, it might be set to 1 meter, so this will look like it's blown up. So you just need to keep calm. We'll put four segments of polys, and it's 250 um because it's so small. So we're going to that real size, okay? So we'll shut that, press spacebar. Let's turn them all on and have a look. And there's the actual chip, okay? So now what we've got to do is, let's have a look. There's these things here. I don't know what on earth they are, but let's do them. So on the main again, let's put everything else in the background. And so there's going to be some kind of holes dug in here. So again, let's go to create. Let's use a box. Actually, we'll go on a new layer and put these in the background. And what we'll do is we'll click and drag out. And it will be using the same settings as before, which, to be fair, I think is fine. And there's what? 2, 4, 6. Let's do 7 or 8 of those things. So what I'm doing in this window is I'm drawing out and moving with the centre bit roughly what I think these should be. Once I've got one and I think, yeah, I'm happy with that, I'm not going to drop it and copy and paste it. I'm just going to see where the orange square is, right mouse click, and it will duplicate. So I'm going to duplicate one, move it along a little bit, maybe just size it in there so it's a little bit smaller, and then do it again, right mouse click. So it's a quick way to cut like make a duplicate of it. Let's make this a bit, and I'm just gonna right mouse. I want to just let me just quickly do a load of these whatever they are. How many is that? They're probably not lined up amazingly. So that's 3, 6. Let's just do one more. Make this a bit smaller. Let's save that. So I've dropped the selection. Now let's use the move tool under modify. Let's just center it so it's in this, it's roughly in the center of all these and close to the edges, maybe like so. Let's flip them round. So what you should have is this, okay? Everything, all the little bits in the background, and you can decide on the sizes. I've done it quite quickly. And again, construct boolean, subtract, it will subtract them. So let's have a look, and let's have a look on texture. There they are. We don't need them things, so delete them off your keyboard. Let's have a look at the whole thing, and there it is, like so. Once you've made this, you can, if you think, well, actually, to me it looks a little bit too fat or thin or long, you can use the size and stretch tool to manipulate them. Do you know what I mean? You can come in and you can stretch it and thin it, and you can do what you want basically if you want. So that's that done. While we're on it, we'll give them some surface names. So on the main here at the bottom, there's a button called set surface, and there's a Q on your keyboard. We'll bring this up and let's call it main body. We'll just give it a rough yellow color from the color picker here. So it's yellow. Next one. Well, these two are the same colour, so we'll select them both like so. And to be honest, just looking at this, let me have a look. I think this probably could have been a little bit more forward, but we'll stick with it. So Q on your keyboard. Let's call this boxes. Let's give it a name. So I want it to be off of this. So if I click, I'm just going to be off screen. If I click on pick from screen and I go over that image, it will choose whatever image, whatever color I go over. So we've got that. And so now what we've got is we've got everything there ready to texture properly. So what we could do is we could select these two. I can Command X, Command V. So they're all on one layer. And now what we need to do is we could just come up with this. So for this, I'm just going to use a disk tool, bevel it a few times, mirror it across, and then select some polygons and bring a glass layer across. And then in here, it was just literally a disk tool that I've actually gone and done the glass little bit here, look. So this is just a disk that I've beveled, and used around a tool. So let's just do that. Okay, so now let's make the disk, so, or the container. So we'll put this in the background. We'll use the disk, press numerical. So this is the last settings I actually use, which is roughly about right based on the size I was doing. So it's 30mm, 30mm, 5.5 thickness. So you kind of get this, which it could be a bit smaller, but let's say we're happy with that. So we'll drop the section. Let's move it using the move tool to the side here, like so. And then what we want to do is we want to make some bevels to make the actual front part. So this is the disc. I've used a rounder tool there, made loads of bevels, and then rounded it off as well. So let's start by selecting polygons at the bottom. And selecting this face here. So what we'll do is we'll use the bevel tool, and I'm holding control and I'm going to bevel it in a very small amount, about that much, okay? Because I'm going to use this row of this radius of polys here as my glass. Once I've done that, I'm going to hold control on my keyboard, and then this time I'm going to right mouse click. I've just undone that to bring it out. And then I'm going to keep right mouse clicking and controlling, dragging left to side, right to right, and so on, till I come up with a kind of shape that's like this, basically. This is the kind of thing I did before. And then what I did is I actually selected these polys here, looks, you see around this row, I keep calling it row, it's not a row, loop. And then what I did is I went over to select and looped it, so I select them all, then I controlled C and control V on my keyboard to paste them. That's going to be our glass when I extrude it. So if we go back to this now, we can just round this. So while it's all selected, let's go on to the rounder numerical, and let's decide how much we want to round it. So this is with 1mm, which is kind of rounding everything, but we could, to go lower than that, let's put 500 um for micro, which again is okay. But what you could do if you don't want to do it all is, let's I mean, there's also the point bits, but we don't need to get into that. What we could do is undo that. You can just do certain bits. So for instance, if I was to select a couple of these edges around this loop, and then select loop, and then use the rounder tool, it will just do this bit for me, like so. I mean, if I jump up to 1mm, you'll get that. Okay, and then you can do it on the others, and also these can stay. In fact, what you could do is you can alternative. So let's say, for instance, I select a few of these edges, looped them. This time, let's say I use the chamfer tool, and this time I chamfer these, so it's giving you a slightly different bevel for each one. And again, for this one, let's see what we can do with this one. Select it, rounder, numerical, and again, it's rounded that. Let's do with this bit, we can just maybe select the polygon. So I'm spacebar, select the polygon. We can chamfer it, do this. And again, it's up to you which edges are harder and which are smoother and so on. And then for the other side, what we could do is let's select this poly at the back. Let's chamfer it a bit. Drop the selection, forward slash and drop selection. Then I'm going to select this poly. We could try roundering it, like round, making it round. And then let's, because it's a bit more poly, let's decide on what we want to do. Like so. So you can have this. But what you've got then is you've got some kind of end that we can kind of use. I mean, we can select this poly and simply just use the team tool and pull it out a bit as well. And just keep going and making the shape you want. But if we put the actual chip in the background, we've got this. So we need another one of these at the other end. So what we'll do is wire the chips in the background and we've got the end selected. Under multiply, let's go to mirror, press N on your keyboard, and then this will mirror across. So what we can do then is you can decide by using the X, if that's the axis you want, how far the gap is. So let's just say, let's just say that. I'll be here all day otherwise. And so we've got two now, like so. And then if you remember, we've got this here, which is the glass. So let's put this in the background. Now we want to extrude the glass across to the other side to make the glass. So there's a few ways you can do this. So the first thing I'm going to do is let's just press F on the keyboard so it's facing outwards. Then we can use the extrude tool and then in the top view, move it across to the other side, making sure that it's straight like so. This line's got to be straight, yeah? And there you've got your, and then you've got your kind of glass. So once it's extruded across, we can select it, press Q on your keyboard, call it glass. Now I'd already got a surface name called glass, and what I've done is I've gone in here and turned the transparency up. You can turn and change the color of the transmitted as well. If it don't show up as glass and transparent like this, if you put everything on and yours looks solid, you have to go into the edit display options, go into GL and make sure this stuff's turned on. Transparency layer, transparency reflections, make sure these are clicked on so you can use them. It's only a representation of it anyway, so. But that's the glass. The other part is the ends, so let's Q on your keyboard. I think I've already gave them a name. No, or have I? No, so let's call it, I'll just call it metal ends, and we'll give it like a darky kind of color, so we've got them, yeah. And so what we've got now is the actual chip inside the container. So the other thing I did, last thing I did really is on the ends here, put the chip in the background, is I selected the inside polys here and I just simply move them forward to make as if it was a piece of glass. So what you do is, because it's face, the polygon's facing that way and we're going to extrude it, we press F to flip it inside, then we extrude it across, and I'm just going to extrude it so it, till it's touching like that. And then on the other side I did the same again, select, press F to flip it first, extrude, and then extrude it so it's kind of touching like that. And then what you can do is in this view here, if you select all the actual polys, all I'm doing is holding shift and like clicking and dragging over so I know I select them all. Then I'm going to give it another name. The reason I'm giving it another name, because I could just call it glass and be part of the other one, but I want that glass to be a bit more less transmitting. So let's call it glass pipes. Okay. Drop that. So let's have a look. Like so. The other things we can do is you can then start adding stuff. So if you want a little handle here, you could add a handle and so on. On the other, this you can't see, but on the other side, I think I've got like some kind of handle that you could make and bring in, or you can put a logo on and so forth. But again, I've done this a lot quicker than I did when I did the original. So this is the original. It's a bit longer, it's a bit thinner. Made this a bit, to be honest, it probably looks a bit more like this one that I kind of found. But yeah, this is the modeling bit anyway, and I've zipped through it. But once you've got this, add some detail, add some stuff, keep going. But what I'll do is I'll do a part two where I'll texture it using and render it using the native Lightwave, but also how to use Octane, so you have two versions of it. So hope you enjoy the tutorial. Sorry I've babbled on too long. Please go and check out Lightwave Salvation Facebook group. It's forever growing. I think we're hitting around 2,000 now, which is not bad to say only 150. And also, please share and subscribe. Look out for the part two. Thanks for listening.